নিজের ক্ষমতা জ্ঞান এবং অধ্যবসায়কে সঙ্গী করে একজন ভারতীয় হিসেবে নিজেকে ইন্টারন্যাশনাল আইটি সার্কিটে সুপ্রতিষ্ঠিত করেছেন ইন্টারা আইটির কর্ণধার অশোক কে লাহা। বর্তমানে যারা এন্টারপ্রেনার হিসেবে নিজেকে আইটি বিজনেসে প্রতিষ্ঠিত করতে চান তাদের জন্য বেস্ট এক্সাম্পল অশোক লাহা। ক্যালকলিংকে দেওয়া এক বিশেষ সাক্ষাৎকারে অশোক লাহা বিশ্লেষণ করলেন আইটি ইন্ডাস্ট্রিতে তার অভিজ্ঞতা লব্ধ বিভিন্ন উপলব্ধির কথা। স্টার্ট আপ কোম্পানিগুলোর কাছে তুলে ধরলেন আগামী দিনের রোডম্যাপ।
গুড আফটারনুন স্যার।
গুড আফটারনুন
এন্ড ওয়েলকাম মিস্টার লাহা টু আওয়ার ক্যালকলিং প্রোগ্রাম এগেইন।
থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ।
সো টুডে উই উইল স্টার্ট উইথ সাম বেসিক ডিসকাশন অ্যাবাউট ইন্টার আইটি এন্ড ইওর জার্নি এন্ড অল দ্যাট।
Okay.
Tell me, Mr. Laha, about your ideas as to how Indian startups can go global in the context of your experience of InterIT.
Well, for a startup to become global, global means that they are, I presume, they are going to sell in the world market. They have to have a product which can be sold in the world market, like a comparable to, maybe not comparable to iPhone, but in the same range, you know, people will buy in. And there are some products there which are sold in the world market. So you have to be innovative, quality has to be very good, and you have to challenge in the world market, and you have to get into the product in the world market.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Now, you have spent a long innings in the US and in big corporate league of IT. So, Mr. Laha, against that background, their lifestyle, way of work culture, work ethics, everything, far away from what we think Indian climate is, work ethics and all that. So, how did you manage to align yourself to that?
Well, you know, I strongly believe in the US culture and work ethics. That's the more like an Anglo-Protestant work culture, you know, that is a very simple fundamental principle, is that you get paid for a 8 hours work, you should actually do something for the work, you know, not goof up, not nothing else. Also, quality is most critical part of it. Something which you'd like to do, which you feel pretty good about it at the end of the day. You like to thrive for anything which you do has to be, can be rated as A, not a C, not a B, at A. That's the US work culture all about, you know, thrive for the best quality. In Indian context, what I've seen it for the last 17, 18 years I'm working here in the environment, the people tend to do the shortcut. People are not mindful of the quality. Or they don't bother too much about the the milestones or deadline. You know, missing the deadline is okay. They think it's acceptable life. US I learned was to, if you don't produce quality or quantity or something like that, you not go any place in the life. Most likely, if you are they'll be branded as a poor performer. And that's then you may lose your job, or your career definitely is limited. That what I've seen is that that's the ethics you have to do that here. At the end of the day, if you want to produce something which is of a global standard, your quality has to be most important part. Quality and the deadline has to be most, those two sacrosanct. So, in my mind, you know, the US work culture can be adopted here. I'm sure that the number of companies here, I've seen it, number of people, they are India-based. but their work culture is very excellent. The quality, excellent. You know, so it can be adopted here. So you have to thrive for it.
Absolutely. So you are talking of excellence, and that
yes.
very practice can be implemented here as well.
That's correct.
Passion for excellence.
Yeah, and that's important. That's important. If you want to play, be a global player. For example, like right now, Prime Minister Modi is talking about Make in India. India, Make in India means that India will be a global manufacturing hub. You have to produce quality, excellence, and you have to compete in the world market. You have to in that range.
Talking of excellence and coming up, going places, what is, Mr. Laha, your strategy to cope with the evolving upcoming technologies? Every year new technologies coming into IT. So new areas, new domains, any plans for that?
Well, I don't think, you know, you have to be very, very agile and adaptive. Today's, you know, if you want to do a business, you have to understand what the technology is going on, where the world is moving, and you have to be, you know, on. You have to follow and you have to adapt very quickly. Otherwise, you'll be dinosaur. You'll die. That's an essential element of a successful businessman. For to succeed in this world, you have to adopt technology. You have to be adopt technology very quickly, and you have to follow through. And you should not be afraid of it. You know,
right.
You have to be on the top of that. You have to embrace the new technology, new changes coming in.
Mr. Laha, our viewers would like to know something about what were, apart from business and profit motives, which every businessman or industrialist has, what other, factors or inspirations or motivations were there, or if you had any partial or full role model which prompted you towards entrepreneurship?
Well, entrepreneurship is interesting. You know, most of us dream to be my own boss. You know, that's the most of people talk about it. When I talk with some entrepreneurs, I don't want to work for anybody. I want to work for myself. But that in essence, that's not true. If you take a venture capital money, or if you take a loan from bank, or if you got some investors, you are actually working for them. You are also working for your customers, because customer doesn't. If you don't have a customers, you have no business to speak of. You know. So in that sense, that's the myth. I'm working for anybody. I don't have a boss. That's the myth. But obviously, entrepreneur has got a advantage is that. You can make your own rules, you know, you have to create your roadmap, you have to create your product plan, you have to create your business model. You got lots of freedom, absolutely lots of freedom to do whatever you want to do, you know. That's the goal. Profit is not a dirty word, profit is the healthy, you know. You have to be profitable, otherwise you have no business to speak up, no. But what else you can drive? I probably say my feeling is to drive is that what drive is to be excellent what you do, to be recognized by somebody, to that you have created something unique and interesting. You know, I envy. You see my role models. I probably say Steve Jobs is one of the guys. No. I admire him tremendously for creating most successful company in the history of the world, you know, Apple Computer, you know, it's an admiration, it's a combination of all of them. And so, you know, see, he'll be a role model, you know, his main mantra is to think different, I follow that quite a lot. That's the most important thing, you know. There are a few other, you know. Steve Jobs, Jack Welch is one of them. I also think of it, you know. But yeah, it's a fun, you know. But you have to be excellent. You like to be excellent. You like to be recognized by any profession you work. Same thing with the entrepreneur. You like to be recognized as one person, something you have done, which is very unique and successful.
We also know that you adore the lines of Steve Jobs, that stay hungry, stay foolish. So, and coming back to something else, your recent programs in Cal College spoke of coaching and mentoring. And we know that you have been an exceptional student in your days, career, both here as well as in the US. So any plans of bridging the gaps with academics or leveraging the academics industry relationship from IIT?
Well, there are two type of things, two angles. One is that you can go to the campus or universities as an adjunct faculty member and teach the students whatever you learned, you know, be management, be HR, be technology, whatever you like to do, and you can pick up a university, you know, and lots of people they do that, you know. That's the one way you can teach. The other one you can do that is to, you can build a, which also you are trying to do, is to, you can build a industry, university relationship. Because most of the people from the industry point of, from the university point of view, most of the students in most of the colleges, they are not prepared to encounter what you expected in the industry life. You know, their knowledge at best is theoretical, they're not there. From the industry point of view, most of the industries, they don't do per se research, long-term research or something like that. They're mainly motivated by the development technology which can bring the money within 12 months, you know. Some big company may do that for the, you know, they can take a 3 or 4 or 5 years return, time spent to return, but most of the companies, they don't do that. University is the place where they do the research. So if you can somehow build a relationship with them, so what you call the applied research, which they can work on your behalf, or they can work together, and that will be tremendous. I know this thing is followed in US universities. My previous company, when I worked in Cadence has got a very strong relationship, the Berkeley. No, I know other universities has got an excellent relationship, MIT, Stanford. So that's very common in the US. That model, you know, university industry relationship, and which you can be done here also, you know, and it has to be win-win for both of us. So that's the one thing we are going to drive at it.
Before we conclude this session, sir, any favorite management mantra or personalities who have inspired
you? I would say two of them. One is the Andy Groves, that only paranoid survive. And the other thing is the Steve Jobs, think different. Those two.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lahar.
Thank you.